let's see what I'm going to read. The first poem I'm going to read is called Air. What if the air turns solid and locks us into place? And only those who are embracing at that moment will be embracing. And only those who are looking at each other then will be looking at each other. Those who just made a promise will never break it. The child counting out loud behind the trunk of a tree will never say 20 behind the trunk of a tree. And all the other children will be hiding, each in a momentary solitude. The man diving from a cliff into the ocean will be diving. This next poem is called In This World. You may think nothing of it, but in this world, there is no health insurance coverage for the dead. But there are retirement plans for those who are not yet born. And though we are registered in the offices of vital statistics, we still ask the questions. Where do we come from? Who are we? Where are we going? You may think nothing of it, but outside one of the toy shops on 14th Street, a battery-driven doll in a diving suit swims in a small metal bowl. Every time it takes a stroke, it rams its head into the side of the bowl. And though there is poverty and high unemployment, we still have the sky, mysteriously blue today, beyond the high, white, mottled clouds. And below it, all the sewing kits of history, personalized stationery, or unpaid bills. Below it, glue, strong enough to hold together the parts of airplanes and watch repair shops, inside of which eternity ticks in the gears and the bearings, and all the butterflies navigating here in the sunlight among the weeds, here in the little garden at the back of the church of Santa Maria Soledad Torres Acosta. Here's another poem, it's called Above the Expressway. Above the expressway, the enormous clouds were spinning in their own ballrooms, in their own twisted cities of light. When they drove past the cemetery where the gravestones floated like crooked teeth in a riot of stillness and silence, she turned to Jack and said, "This is what we'll all come to." He smoked at the wheel and she went on. "Just look, it doesn't matter if you own things, land or houses or cars. When you're dead, you'll fit right below one of those gravestones." "Yeah," he said, "but when I die, don't bury me. Take me out on the ocean in a boat and push me over. Let the fish feast on me." Two more poems. No, actually three. I started three, so 3 hours more maybe. This is called, I had a teacher once who prefaced everything he said with "in the final analysis." Everything. So I couldn't resist to write this poem one day. What is, it's called Final Analysis. What if in the final analysis, there is no final analysis? What if it just goes on, the way the clouds go on floating this evening over all the invisible bank accounts, and over the rubble that holds the details of our lives. And what if it's not unlike a film strip of seconds that flows through the years, through all the places we have ever been, even briefly, such as a doorway we stood in while it rained, or a roadside wreck site we passed with its small white cross in the dark on Route 14, or for that matter, the entire city of the moon, or Cleveland, seen from an airplane as it weaves its way down through the higher layers of the air, inside of which we are, and which is everywhere now, equally clear. And this next one is actually a holiday poem, surprisingly enough. It actually takes place in the storefront of a second-hand clothing store. One that's actually not that very many steps away from here, up the street. You might recognize it as a reader. Holiday sale at the second-hand store. Who the hell dressed the storefront mannequin? They look like whores back from war. They have missing or broken off limbs, and the tousled wigs are on backwards and sideways. Just take this one messy blonde in a red, torn, sequined gown. She has something on her mind. You can tell by the way she grins and holds up her hand as if about to say something profound. Then, of course, there is her friend, the headless one, who sports a pearl necklace and a tight dark blue skirt with slits and rhinestones, leaning in a little wobbly in her high heels with a tray of, could it be eggnog? But mind you, at their feet is a man mannequin lying face down on the green astroturf floor. He has no arms, but wears a dark suit. And there is a Santa hat that must have flown off his head as his face slammed down. How about something strong, Mr. Mannequin? How about a hand or an arm or something? What we have is this ever-evolving crescent as it oozes forth empty-handed trees along the tracks and the neglected backsides of diners and little shops where nobody sits to see how it occurs in the frozen light, but a man is carrying a ladder on his shoulder across a parking lot that floats past just before the turquoise plastic fence that runs along the recycling plant in Mineola. All of a sudden, yesterday, my 7-year-old son asked, where is the future? And walking next to me on the street, pointed ahead and added, is it over there? If you had to choose, would you choose the news or the clouds? Would you do laundry or sit down with Nietzsche at the rickety kitchen table? Would you raise the flag of happiness or the flag of a broken nail? the skull or the guitar, the invisible pencil tip of the present is drawing something that is simultaneously being erased, and we can never leave where we are. Thank you so much.